Toasted. Sauce board. Pizza toast win. Gang stalker failure.
Eat my ass.
What the crisis is happy or shit?
That looks pretty good, right, folks? You got corn, you got potatoes, that's Jason Avocado's original.
I ain't gonna count to three. I'm not even gonna count to one. You will shut the fuck up or I'll sing you a lullaby.
Hey! Let me speak!
Alright, hey guys, so this is a Rev original dish. And Shanny said that's some stoner shit right there. So this is what it is. This is Rev's rice, man.
I like booty.
This is rice cooker rice, Concord grape jelly, and generic brand creamy peanut butter.
I like it. I want you.
No!
They can break you in two. So never sniff inhalants.
We're gonna make cheese great again.
Listen, I know it's hard to believe, but all of these meals were made using top ramen.
Really? Ramen noodles?
That's right, bitch. Hey, it's your girl Kathy, and I got a new recipe book where everything is made using top ramen. I know this is all your broke ass got in the pantry, but don't worry, I'm gonna show you how to eat like a king. It's a goddamn pandemic the way people have been eating top ramen wrong all these years. We're about to fix that. First, we've got a barbecue beef pasta. And it's so easy to make. You just make beef and then you put the top ramen on the top and then a whole jug of ketchup and a whole can of soda. It's lit. Whoa, let's see that barbecue beef pasta in action. Just put a little cheese on top and no one's ever gonna know you're a cheap bastard. You see that shit right there? That ain't delivery. That's ramen. Bellissimo. You see, these other cookbooks tell you how to make a chicken casserole, but what they don't tell you is you can put two packets of top ramen on top and then a whole bucket of gravy. And just like that, dinner is served. Hey, fatso, trying to lose weight? Well, how about you stop being a basic bitch and start getting a little extra by putting a little top ramen on top with some light vinaigrette. That means light vinaigrette in Italian. Ooh, what's this? I bit my cheek. Don't worry, I got desserts too. Have you ever had a spicy ramen baked pie a la mode?
Who knew that the salty chicken flavored ramen would go so well with my berry crumble recipe? I mean, get out of town.
All right, y'all, let's break it down. This book is in full color and it's only $10. But wait, I'm also gonna throw in the ramen nibbles. That's a party pack. We got the Ramadan bonbons, pureed red pepper ramen dip, and my personal favorite, spicy choco chicken ramen cakes. And that's only on the first page. There's over 100 recipes. The possibilities are endless!
All right, shut up, Shanny. Hello, hello, hello. I only see Iconic in the chat, so she's the only one that's going to get any love from me. How you doing, Iconic? Oh, sorry for all my headphone users there. I just peaked a little bit. Still getting used to this new mic. Still love it, though. Anyway, I know it's been... I know I didn't stream at all last week. You could say it's a Shanny excuse. I worked a 13-hour shift straight, and it just wiped me for the entire week, so... I was like, if I don't have the energy to give my chat the love that they deserve, then I'm just not going to stream. Hi, Tangle Bliss. Hi, Iconic. You two are the only ones here right now, so you're the only two that I'm paying attention to. Or you're the only two that are chatting, so you're the only two that I'm paying attention to. Anyway, I figured that we would go back in time and watch one of Shanny's terrible cooking streams. Hi, Freddie. There's our third one. I figured we could go back in time and watch one of Shanny's terrible cooking streams. Just to see where she came from and how disgusting her cooking actually is, because it's absolutely revolting. And we are doing the infamous one where she attempts to make mac and cheese and carrot cupcakes. Spoiler alert, there is going to be tinfoil involved somewhere. And I'm surprised there wasn't a fire involved somewhere. But anyway, I figured I'd start off this week with a good old Shanny shit show. And unfortunately, since this thing is all in one stream, we will not have the same palate cleanser. Which is why I went ahead and put my traditional Djibouti dubs video in the beginning of the stream. But anyway, this thing is an hour long, so we're going to have some fun with it. And it might be a short stream, it might be a long stream, I don't know. It depends on how much shit I can find to talk about while I'm doing this. So anyway, let's get this started. Let me go ahead and get my... Oh, turn that down just a touch. There we go. There we go. Because I gotta have the anthem for my channel. Hey, Tubian. Yes, cat hair is another ingredient in this. So we'll see. We'll get through all of the ingredients that she adds to this. But spoiler alert, there is tinfoil involved. So let's get the shit show started, shall we?
What up? How you guys doing? We got some birthday stuff. I'm here. What's up, Adele? What's up, B? What's up? I'm here. And my son woke up this morning and I was like, what would you like for your birthday? What would you like to eat? What dinner would you like to eat? Well, he gave me one thing that he wanted to eat. He wanted specifically Kraft macaroni and cheese, done mommy's way. So
in other words, he wanted Kraft macaroni and cheese with a side of salmonella poisoning. Got it.
We're gonna do some Kraft macaroni and cheese mommy's way. Along with cooking some chicken.
Oh, I'm sorry about that, Tangled Bliss. Hopefully this will not ruin your app. And I hope you're not having macaroni and cheese.
Chicken nuggets.
No, Iconic. These are not the ones that she licks the frosting off of. As I said in the beginning. Spoiler alert, there is tinfoil involved. You'll just have to wait and see.
And also, we're going to hit these up in the microwave. Have you ever tried these? These bird's eye... broccoli, like, sauced. You just hit this in the microwave for how many minutes? Looks like 5 minutes. 5 minutes in the microwave. Boom. You got veggies. I like that. But he also wanted some carrot cake. Now, my oldest made him also a cake today. You know, he's gonna have double the cake today. Along with a nice French vanilla ice cream. It's gonna be so good. So good. He knows it. I know it. We all know it.
And just a... Yeah, not weird at all. But, I mean, to be honest, when she released those texts between her and her oldest, I was definitely getting some Sweet Home Alabama vibes. So that may have just been me. But, yeah, it's a little bit weird. But, yeah, I will make this little note before we get too far into it. This stream took place while they were still in Colorado. So they're still in that very expensive, brand new apartment complex that costs them $3,000 a month. So you're going to see how much damage she did to that place before they left. And mind you, this is before Drag Shit Ninjas got a hold of it. Because we all know the Drag Shit Ninjas were the ones that just ruined everything. They just messed up everything. So we're going to see how they went back in time and messed up everything while Shanny was streaming this. It's going to be amazing.
So,
I mean, for one thing, I hate to turn it back, but...
So, we're going to just... Week the recipe off this, like, Betty Crocker's super moist carrot cake. We're going to tweak it a little bit, first of all.
I mean, because for one thing, if you look right here, look at that dirt that's just right there in that seam right here. Ugh. Oh, good. McDonald's is going to be a whole lot better than this shit. But look at that dirt cake just caked and baked on. And I'm going to make this point probably throughout the entire stream, that this apartment that they're living in Colorado was a brand new apartment. It had just been built when they moved in. They were the first occupants of this apartment. So she did all this. All of this crap right here, all of it, that's all her. And I just now noticed that if you look right here, there's actually a dip. There's like, there, it looks almost like a separation between the panel and the actual oven. So looks like she broke that shit too.
There's not going to be any nuts in it. We're not going to allow the nuts being in it. No, 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 no. That is not what we're going to do. Because my son has a really bad nut allergy. So we're not adding nuts to it. And there is no nuts in this. I already read it like thoroughly like 5 million times just to make sure there's no nuts in this. To which I am happy to say there is no nuts in this recipe. So moms, if you want to give your child a killer carrot cake, get this brand. Just right there. So I'm gonna tweak it just a little bit by using just one can of pineapple chunks. Yep, one can of pineapple chunks. We're just gonna tweak it just a little. So I'm gonna basically just can open this. Just open it with the cans.
And yes, guys, she did do all of her cooking streams from this fucking chair. And I don't know about her, but I don't think pineapple goes very good with carrot cake. Ugh. But yeah, iconic. Yeah, part of the granite counter was missing. But, oh god, these famous substitutions. Holy shit.
How all of you guys? You guys look all good. So happy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the juice. You need 1 cup of water, according to the recipe. But I'm going to go and I'm going to take the juice from the pineapple, the can of pineapple, and use that in replace of the water. You see what I'm doing?
Now, I will say that there are, yeah, there are certain things that you can do to tweak a cake recipe. I spent a few months working at an adult daycare, and part of that was that I had to make their midday snack. And so one day it was a root beer float cake. And so what they wanted me to do was they had the cake box mix, and I want to say they had like the regular, like the regular vanilla one, but instead of using water, I used root beer for both the cake and to make the icing with it. So, there are ways that you can actually tweak these things, but this ain't it, Chief. Hi, Blue! How you doing, darling? But yeah, this ain't it, Chief. This really ain't it. Look how big those damn chunks are. Holy shit, woman.
So, we gotta get these pineapple out. Clean hands. Remember, clean hands. But we're just gonna... Let me see. Should I do it that way?
Why don't you use a strainer?
I'll make it easier.
Don't put the top of
in a 1 cup container, of course.
Spoiler alert, guys. That cup set doesn't stay together long.
Wonder if there's 1 cup of juice. Oh my god, folks. I think there's like exactly... Yeah. Pretty much exactly 1 cup of pineapple juice in a can of pineapples. That's awesome! So it's a perfect amount for the water. Yas, queen.
No, queen. Please, no.
So you can see it.
And she just dripped juice all over that stovetop.
That's awesome. That makes me so happy. Look at those. So gorgeous. We're going to taste test one, of course.
Of course. Shanny's got to
eat. Why wouldn't I taste test a pineapple?
Nine times out of ten, when she did these cooking streams, she was high as a fucking kite. So, yeah, she's probably got the munchies. But, I mean, look at how big those pineapple... When she dumps them in the bowl, just look how big those fucking pineapple chunks are.
Oh! I love...
Hello, life as a music gamer. Yeah, my eye twitches every time I see her cook, too. No. That's just... That ain't it, Chief. That really ain't it, Chief.
Love pineapple. Now, pineapple is actually really high in vitamin C. It's also really good for people who have arthritis because it helps, like, take down the inflammation. And it's also... Did you know about pineapple juice that it's a cough suppressant? So, if you have a really bad cough, drink some pineapple juice. See how it, you know, does ya. Let me put this over to the side real quick.
Look at how nasty that stovetop is. Oh my, ugh. I've said this before in my other streams where I've actually watched some of her cooking streams, that I have a glass top stove myself at my house. My glass top stove is at least 10 years old. Because we got it from my grandmother when she redid her kitchen. So we just replaced my mom's old electric coil stovetop with the glass top one that we have now. Ours doesn't look nearly that dirty. It does not look nearly that bad. And it's like 10 years. It's like, if not 10 years, more than 10 years old. That thing's been there for a while. And it's just like, ugh. Oh my god, look at all that nasty shit. Oh my god, and she's just gonna make it worse. Oh, another fun fact about pineapple juice is that if you have trouble with swelling in your leg, Shanny, a cup of pineapple juice will actually help flush the fluid out. It's actually a diuretic as well.
We gotta open this up. Well, as you can see, if I stood up, it would be a weird angle and you wouldn't be able to see my face, so it's a good angle.
That would actually be a benefit if we couldn't see your face.
Simple question, angles. We have to, like, remember angles.
What the fuck do angles have to do with your inability to open a plastic bag? And I will say, those plastic bags are hard to get open too. I use scissors on mine, personally.
Alright. Now. Pretty simple. You dump it in.
No shit. I want you guys to look right here at this part of the screen. Look at how messed up that fucking burner is. Millie! Don't bark. But look at how messed up that burner is. Holy shit. Like I said, I've got a glass top stove and it's over 10 years old and our burners do not look anything like that. Ugh.
Oh, that smells so good. Oh.
Some people have crack. Shanny has apparently pre-mixed pre-mixed cake mix.
It's like spice heaven. It's okay. It's flour on my face. Don't worry about it. So...
There she goes, wiping her face with her goddamn
pineapple juice. one cup of pineapple juice. Oh, crap. Come here, boss. 2/3 cups of vegetable oil.
Oh, my God. I'm sorry to keep pausing it, guys, and I'm probably going to pause it because you know how I like to talk. But I just cannot get over how messed up that freaking glass top stove is. I can't get over it. It is just, it's a complete and utter disaster area. But yet they blamed it on the shit ninjas. This is all of this dirt that you see here and all this messed up shit, that's from the shit ninjas. That's from drag shit ninjas. They went back in time and they did all this, they dirtied up all of this shit while Shanny wasn't looking, and she never noticed. But of course, we all know how observant Shanny is. I bet she probably would have actually missed any shit ninjas that came through, even if they ran by. Oh my God, I just noticed that in the stream. Holy crap, that thing's gone. I really, really, really hope that whoever owns these apartments, I hope they go after these two for damages, because holy shit, that's a lot of damages. Hey cats, how you doing, sweet pea?
2/3 cup of vegetable oil, folks.
Yes, music one, gamer, I have seen that one.
2. And then I'm pretty sure 1 egg. No.
And she, and another thing drives me insane is that she uses her fucking sink as a garbage can. She uses the sink as a fucking garbage can. Who does that?
3 eggs.
She just got egg all over that stove.
1.
Eggs all over the stove.
2.
I will give Shanny credit. I will give her this much credit. Her egg cracking game is on point. I can't do egg cracking with one hand. So she's got me on that one. Other than that, no.
Stop it. Stop falling on me.
It's funny how they had this countertop damage the entire time. And Shanny, with her immaculate cleaning, she couldn't be bothered to get someone to come in and fix it. I wonder why. It's a mystery we'll never solve. Oh yeah, we want to hear about the granite countertop. Lucian, give us the deets.
Butter makes everything better. I ain't putting butter in this. Pineapple juice, good enough, baby. It's rich enough. All right.
You want to hear the story behind this mixer? She bought that mixer. It's a hand crank mixer. She bought it because... Hey, Slipknotty. She bought it in case they had a power outage, so that way if she wanted to bake something, she could. Forgetting that her stove and her oven are also electric. Let's see. Lucian says, let's just say Shanny should have known that the countertop wouldn't have been able to, you know, be able to hold up the weight. Oh, did she sit on it? Oh, Lord. Yes, that definitely would break the countertop. That would break anything. I don't know. Maybe Rev tried to fuck her on the countertop. I mean, because we all know that he's not getting his little pee-pee in her gray twat waffle anytime soon because there's too much there. Ugh, Shanny, just get a spoon. Get a spoon to mix it. Get a spoon.
I love this thing. This is like a crank mixer, by the way.
Just get a spoon. Get a spoon, Shanny.
So you don't need electricity. You see how I think? I'm like, if their electricity comes out, we're gonna need some kind of utensil for making bread and stuff and dough and stuff. So I figured one.
Even if your power did go out and you wanted to make bread dough, how the fuck would you bake it? Your oven is electric, bitch. It's not going to work in a power outage.
Why not a crank mixer? And it works just as good. Plus, you get a little workout. Look at that.
Oh, oh Lord. She's gonna get...
Look at that.
It's not mixed entirely, Shanny. You could have just got that from the beginning. That is so soupy.
Yeah, it's perfect. Perfect consistency. Now, the next thing we're gonna do... You love your KitchenAid? Me too. All right.
Oh, Lord, look how big those chunks pineapples. Are. And she's gonna make...
All in there.
Let me remind you, she's gonna make cupcakes.
Okay.
Hey, Perpetual.
Pop those pineapples in there and just, you know, I'm gonna get this better angle for you. Just kind of fold them in. Make sure they're evenly distributed.
Oven. That poor stovetop. I weep. And she does everything, every single step of her cooking, she does on the stovetop. She has a ginormous kitchen. Oh yeah, Slipknotty. We're going back to a classic. She has a huge kitchen, mind you. A huge, brand new kitchen. They were the first ones to use this kitchen. It has a kitchen island, lots of counter space. I would kill for that much counter space. I've got one fucking counter in my kitchen. And that's taken up with the toaster oven. I have to do a lot of my prep work on my glass top stove because I have no other place to do it. That or a folding table, one of the two. Because our house is so small and the way that our kitchen is situated, I only have one counter. I would kill for that much counter space. But holy shit, she does everything on this stovetop. I wonder why she does everything on that stovetop. Maybe it's because she doesn't want to move the camera and let us see what the rest of her kitchen looks like.
Beautiful.
Just saying.
Put that aside real quick.
Yeah, she has no space. She has junk everywhere.
Now.
Yeah, we're going back to a classic there.
The next thing we need to do is make some cheap little dinky like holders. For our muffin pan, I'll show you how to do that.
Oh Lord, this was the spoiler.
If you don't
alert.
Have muffin, you know, tins or muffin papers or anything like that, you can use aluminum foil.
No.
Just cut off a little bit of sides
on
them.
Oh my God, no.
Okay.
I told you guys aluminum foil was coming in.
Cut. Four about the same size as this.
Oh my God. We're not that far into the stream and already I want to kill myself.
Alright.
Oh my God.
Isn't I'm giving you some cheap Lord. Skills here, okay?
No, this is not cheap. No, if you want a cheap skill, you take your, which, spoiler alert, she does. You take your olive oil, you put it on a napkin, and you line the fucking cupcake tins with the olive oil. They pop right out. I've done it. I've made cupcakes without the cupcake holders. It's easy to do if you got fucking oil, and you do. You just put it in the cake batter. Oh, but it's going to hurt a lot more, guys. It's going to hurt a lot more in a few minutes.
Cheap skills. Now you want to all align the paper so it's like nice and even, like so. And you just want to cut it.
Oh no, not, no, no. You have a cutting board, Shane. Evidently. You have a cutting board. Oh my God. And she's doing in this thirds. Right on the glass top stove. Right on top of it. Oh my God.
If it gets a little, you know, broken on the sides, don't worry about that.
Oh my God. I forgot what a headache there's this one. Is.
Break that up a little bit.
Oh my
God. There's two. All right.
Oh.
Now, what you want to do.
I need to remind everyone that she's making this for her youngest son's birthday. Her autistic son. Hi, Auntie. Uh-oh, there's a mod in the chat, guys. But it's Auntie, so you don't have to hide your hookers and blow. You can keep those out.
Is, of course, you want to grease your pan or your muffin tins. Oh, God, that's so much oil. Okay.
Oh, my God.
That's all we need.
Why would you grease
the...
Why would you...
brush? Do I? No. All right, I'll just take that and put it in each little thing. It's no biggie. This is only for it to stick, so...
If you, oh my God, if you have the papers and shit, you don't need to oil the tin as well. You don't have to. You can do one or the other. It's possible, Shanny. Although, who am I kidding? She's fucking high as a kite right now.
No biggie to me.
Hi, Queen. Yeah, you just got to the best part. She's using a spoon.
Now take your fingers, rub it in.
No.
Like so.
No. Oh my God, no.
Don't worry, I'm gonna drain like big puddles of oil. Cause that's just gross, but I need to cover this. Alright.
Oh, she's dumping the oil right into her fucking
like so. Alright. So you take your aluminum foil.
And need I remind you guys that she just threw a bunch of trash in that sink, too. Oh my God. Ah.
Right? And you fold it in half. Like
that's because
so.
We can't see much of
and
her point.
And you just pop it in and you mold it about. And there you go. You got a nice muffin tin.
Mm.
So you don't have to ruin your pan. Just a cheap way how to do it. You can make it look nicer or not.
Mmm, that's gonna taste delicious. I bet those kids are still shitting aluminum foil. I can tell you this much. I bet Zach ate the cake that William made for him.
See? I teach you something while you do this, you know? Because now that I have no money, I gotta do things the poor way. But that's okay. I kinda like it because it like really makes me more creative.
This is creative, guys. We're watching Gordon Ramsay right here.
YouTube mob, what is the trick to getting stains out of Tupperware bowls?
Soap and water. Ugh. No, it doesn't. No, Tangled. It does really does not help. I have made cupcakes before. I've made muffins. I've made cupcakes. I've never done this. And I don't use the cupcake papers either way. All I do is oil the fucking tin. That's all you have to do. Oil the tin. You don't have to oil the tin and line it. Because what if you use paper, the paper cupcake holders that you get in the store for like cents, for like pennies. If you'd use those, they would have soaked all that oil up. You're a fucking dumbass.
Being poor brings out your inner artist. Yes, it does.
Auntie, that does qualify as a snipe, and I don't mind. You guys are free to watch me on the Discords. That way you guys can chat and tell me how bad of a job I'm doing. You guys can talk about me behind my back. I really don't care. I know you guys are sitting there going, shut the fuck up.
It makes me feel more creative. I actually like it. Enjoy it a little bit more. It's more of a challenge. And, I don't know. I just enjoy it.
Yes, they do have the silicone holders now.
I'm weird. What can I say?
You're not weird. You're ghetto. And you're just stupid. No, I wouldn't even say you're ghetto. I wouldn't even say you're being ghetto right now. You're just being dumb. That's it. I mean, because look at her sleeve. Look right here on her sleeve. She's just soaked up all... And it drives me insane that she wears this cardigan throughout most of this process. And she only takes it off, like, later on after she's already done all the damage. And she can't even bother to take the rings off. Ugh. I forgot how much this hurts. I had forgotten. Really forgotten how much it hurts. No, she's not. She's not good at anything. She fails at everything.
These are gonna be the best cupcakes in the world.
No, they're not. Because first of all, those your poor man's cupcake liners are not going to come off of those cupcakes easily. They're going to be picking tinfoil from them. And they're probably still shitting tinfoil, I would imagine. Well, maybe not, because I'm pretty sure that the salmonella that they're going to get from the rest of your cooking is probably flushing that out of their system. Probably flush that out of their system. And people wonder why when Rev did his mukbangs, because they used to do these in pairs. Mush is gonna, it's gonna be terrible. But they used to do these, they used to actually do these streams in pairs, which I thought was actually a really good idea. What they used to do is they used to actually have Shanny do her cooking stream like this, and then afterwards, Rev would do a mukbang stream where he would eat what Shanny cooked for him. And it was always entertaining because Rev always had a bottle of Pepto-Bismol right there. Nothing says that your girlfriend's cooking is good like having a Pepto-Bismol chaser.
It's a pretty ring. Oh, this one? Thank you. Thank you.
It looks like something I'd get out of a cheap bath bomb.
Rev got it for me for Christmas.
It looks like something I would get out of a cheap bath bomb or one of those candles that
have a ring
inside.
It's one of those Vancaros, I guess.
Oh, yes, please. Please, please, queen, share those.
Guys,
the oil isn't
for the aluminum foil. The oil is in case some of the batter gets on the pan and I can easily clean it off.
Yes, because we all know that you clean your dishes. We all know that you clean your dishes. That's why in one of your streams, I remember you, and I think, I want to say this is the tortilla stream, that when she pulled out those two flat pans to flatten her tortillas, one of them, they were both dirty when she pulled them out of the cabinet. So yeah, we all know you wash your dishes, Shanny. Oh, queen, the extra foil so the boys can get
now
the aluminum in their diet.
To spoon it in. Make sure to have some pineapple for each.
That won't be hard with how big those chunks are. Oh my god. And she's getting batter all over that stove now, too.
This is gonna be so good.
You are so high. You think that's gonna be good?
I'm making sure each of these have like two pineapples each, so it'd be like nice and yummy, and the pineapple cooks down.
Well, I mean, Tangled Bliss. One of the problems, one of the reasons why they ran out of money so quickly, wasn't just the fact that they bought toys and drugs with them. It's because every single time they moved to a new location, they would leave everything behind and buy new shit when they got there. That's why you don't see her in these cooking streams with a lot of cooking utensils, because every single time they moved, she'd just leave all that shit behind. And that was part of the reason why they lost so much money, because they kept buying new stuff for every single house they moved to. Although I want to say that all the furniture in this house, including like their bed, was from Rent-A-Center. So, God, I would hate to be the person from Rent-A-Center who has to come get that shit out of that house. Oh my God, that must have been terrible.
And it'd just be like a nice, sweet bite.
Ah!
No pineapple. Over here. Over there.
Ugh. This bitch has never heard of standing up to cook. Ugh, she's not even getting that much batter in them. Most of them are... There she goes. Finally! Look, guys, Shanny can stand up. It only took her how long? Yeah, there's like no batter in there. There's no batter in there. Oh, wait till you see what she does with the extra batter.
Now I'm just gonna just fill everything to the top.
Oh yeah, didn't you guys know she could work for Gordon Ramsay? Oh no, you don't fill them up that much. No, they're gonna overflow.
They're gonna be huge.
They're gonna overflow. You don't put that much batter in there, bitch. You don't. But she was trained by all Italians. Queen of Spades, she was trained by her Italian grandmother.
There we go.
That's how she learned how to make homemade marinara sauce. That might be another one that we go over.
I have extra batter.
Oh my God, you don't fill them up that much.
I have a bunch of batter.
You don't.
Like, y'all, I thought this was only going to do 12. It looks like it can do 24 cupcakes. So.
Oh, wait till you see what she does with the extra batter.
I think what I'll do... Actually, with this,
oh,
because we're not gonna eat this much cupcakes. We don't eat a lot of sugar in this house.
Oh please, but, yes. This your pyramid body. Your pyramid body surely tells the tale of the fact that you don't eat much sugar in this house. Okay, keep saying that.
What I'm gonna do?
Hi, Saint Ratty.
This is just how I cook. Okay.
Oh yeah, St. Ratty, that's because you missed the secret ingredient that she put in these. These are carrot cake cupcakes with giant pineapple chunks in them. So yeah, there you go. That's why it looks so chunky.
Okay guys, I constantly cook in store. Let me put this in the oven. It'll take like 14 to 19 minutes.
And they're gonna overflow. Those things are gonna overflow.
What do you mean it's not gonna cook all the way through? Of course it is.
Oh, I gotta pause, guys. I'm sorry. I keep pausing, I know. But look at that poor... Oh, my God. I weep. I weep for that poor glass top stove. Because I look at mine. I look at the one that me and Mama Shaw have. And I just think about the fact that it's over 10 years old. And it does not look near... No. I mean, it looks... It's definitely showing its age. But it does not look nearly that bad. Not nearly. This is like oil and egg and just batter everywhere. And she's burned... She has destroyed these two burners. She's destroyed this... This stove is... What's that about, Millie? Goodness gracious, girl. Did you have a nightmare? She just woke up and yipped. But it's like, oh my God. Oh, that is so, I weep for that poor. That thing was thrown away. There is no way. There is no way that they kept this stove. No way that they kept this thing after they moved. This entire, I'm pretty sure that they had to go in and just pretty much gut this entire place. Just gut it. Oh, wait until this is gonna be entertaining, guys. This is entertaining. That's a popcorn. This thing right here that she's stuffing the bag into is a thing that you pop popcorn in.
A little trick how to fill up a bag. Let me stand up again.
Ugh, this is entertaining. They haven't even taken the paper out of that thing. You can see right down here at the bottom of the screen where my mouse is pointing to. That's the instructions for the popcorn maker, for the popcorn bowl. They didn't even take that shit out yet. Hi, Panda. She's dripping, just dripping that shit all over the place. Ugh.
Now, what I'm gonna do with this batter is I'm gonna...
Gee, I wonder why she never called a maintenance man in to fix that thing.
Put it in the freezer.
It's gonna be... She's not gonna be able to get that out of there.
Let me wash this bag off. I'll put it in the freezer and I'll use it next time for pancakes.
She's not gonna be able to get that thing out of there.
Great pancake batter. I think I'm gonna leave it actually in here with it zipped up. Let me wash this off real quick.
Oh my god, that poor stove. That poor glass top stove. Oh my god. Here's the fun part, guys. She battered the batter. Yes, she is. Here's the fun part. If you go and if you can find a way to find the footage of the tour of their apartment, when they go to look in the fridge, a lot of these leftovers were still in the fridge. They didn't eat any of the leftovers, and I wonder why. Yeah, don't put it in the freezer. Put that thing in the fridge if you're going to reuse it. Don't put it in the freezer. And she puts that whole thing in the fridge.
There we go.
And she's not wearing a bra either.
Pancake batter, folks. That'll be good.
No, it won't. It'll be disastrous. Oh my god. But look, guys. Shanny can stand. She can move around. She's using a scratch pad. No. Don't use a scratch pad. Maybe you should have thought about cleaning your stove before this. Oh my god. And her titties are just flopping all over the damn control panel. Bitch, wear a bra. No. Oh my god. Look at all the streaks.
Okay.
Look at all the streaks. Look at the tin. Look at the piece of tin foil.
Next thing. Let me put this up for
you
guys.
Yes, because what we need to see is your face. I'm still thinking... Marco Solo is still in my thoughts and prayers, guys. Don't forget, always remember Marco Solo. He's that poor little tooth that's just barely hanging on the right side of her mouth. Oh my god. Well, it'll be her left, alright.
Considering how the Cinco de Mayo food...
Look at all of the grease on her sleeves! Look at all the grease on her fucking sleeves! Ugh. That's all that nastiness that was on the stove.
Turned out my interest has peaked. Don't worry.
And now she's rubbing your nose.
Everything's gonna be okay, man. My nose is so itchy right now. Ugh.
I guess it's that batter that you inhaled.
In the city. It's gonna turn out amazing.
Yeah, sure.
Amazing!
Uh-huh.
So...
Oh yeah, it's definitely gonna be liquid on the inside.
It's gonna take to cook this 10 to 13 minutes. Alright. We'll just wait for the cupcakes to be done. And then I'll start the other portion of dinner. We'll just talk right now.
Oh lord.
Oh, it's not my hubby's birthday, it's my son's birthday.
Your poor son.
Amazing is the thing in today's cooking videos that I've never...
And someone was asking... I saw the comment earlier. I can't remember who said it, but someone was asking what was on her eyes. That's her eye makeup. She had done a stream before this one, I want to say it was, where she did this terrible eye look at the same time she was cussing out her ex-husband, Chris, because Chris had gone on and done an interview with Geek Room. And so she had done this, but it looks like someone just punched her in the eye. Now, I want to say she actually originally did this for a different stream. And I think this is just makeup. She just didn't wash off her face.
Notice.
Oh, no, Perpetual. Don't you remember? That was just balsamic vinegar. Yeah, they should definitely be spoiled on their birthday. Do you think she got him anything? No.
Where's Rev? He's upstairs.
Now he's upstairs. Roll your sleeves up. Now that they're soaked in fucking grease.
You know what? It'll take just as long to, like, boil water. So, I'll just start boiling some water for you guys.
Now, I will say in Shanny's defense, I know this takes a long... I know the water takes a long time to boil, but I've had this pointed out to me by some other people that... this point they're in Colorado, so they're actually at a higher elevation, and so that way it takes longer for water to boil at a higher elevation than it does at a normal elevation. But she should have figured that into her cooking time as well. So if she was actually the professional chef she claims to be, but yeah.
You know, Rev, you've been summoned. My love.
Yeah, Perpetual. Filming in progress.
My beautiful man. The wind beneath my wings.
I will say this much. At least she's got her hair up in this one. Just look at all that crusted on shit in that damn stove. Oh my god. That was a beautiful stove. That just blows my mind. That fucking stove. Yeah.
What was it about?
It's my first official. This is a big deal. Look at the thumbnail. My first ever Colorado welfare EBT mukbang.
You're welcome, love. Oh my There's God. Rev. He didn't say hi to you guys.
Well, what are you lucky to say? I'm here. You could probably see me in the background.
Rob, sleeves, they're your friends, darling.
This kitchen is massive.
The famous kitchen chair, courtesy of Chantel. Yes, exactly. But it's the angle.
No, it's just because you're fucking
lazy. Angle of the food in the face.
No, because you don't want to put your face in the food.
Chantel and Pete's don't do that.
No.
You're my lioness. Ugh. You're beautiful, gold.
No. Someone said, I hope you're getting right with God, my brother. He's always been right with God, but...
And that's why he's shacking up with a cow. Doesn't he know... Doesn't he know that it's against the Bible to sleep with a pig? Doesn't he know that? I could have sworn it said something in there. You definitely are not haram, I'll tell you that much. Ugh. Or, yeah, you definitely not. No. No, you're all bacon grease.
Yeah. Right?
Just waiting for boiling water. You're watching literally right now water boiling. Congratulations. This is the height of my epic cooking skills right now.
Yeah, Auntie, this was... Yeah, cat piss. Her bra smells like cat piss. But this was actually, I would say, like, one of the starts of her really not taking care of herself and not bathing. Because you can see how dirty and nasty her hair is in this. It just went downhill from there. I think this was starting to get to the point where she couldn't fit into the shower anymore. And so that way she just figured that she just wouldn't bathe. But Shanny, even if you can't bathe, you can still fling your head over the side of that sink and wash your fucking hair. Okay? I used to wash people's hair in bed. They make these wonderful inventions for the medical field for people who cannot get up and take a shower. They're called shower caps. And they're actually little caps. They look like regular shower caps that people use to keep water off their hair. And what they are is actually inside of them is a pad that has shampoo in it. And you can actually plop it on their head and shampoo their hair like that. And then just use a rag continuously to rinse it off. There is a way to wash your hair while you're bedbound. And that's how we used to do it in the medical field. But, you know, Shanny's not going to do that much work.
Safeway welfare foods.
Janice, you know, I just...
Blocking. Time to block.
Please grow up someday. Please grow up someday.
You're telling her to grow up? Bitch, you can't even clean a stove. You have burnt that stove.
Do you like cooking? Yes, I do. I love cooking. Please do a makeup tutorial. I will. I actually am planning on doing a cosplay of Jessica Rabbit.
Yeah, man.
So.
I wish I could have seen that.
I know if I put a lid on it, fine.
I would have loved to have seen that.
You guys are so bossy. Put a lid on it. You put a lid on it.
If you put a lid on it, it'll boil faster, bitch. That's why they were telling you to do that. She's high as a fucking... Again, it drives me insane.
Can we just, like, chill out and be friends, folks?
Yeah.
No.
Do we have to be, like, all, like...
But... Holy shit, I just noticed this. No. Yeah, we need to talk about whoever told her. I don't wear makeup a lot. I really don't. I only wear makeup really when I'm doing my cosplays. I don't wear it day to day. But I can do better makeup than that. Honestly. Really can. But I just noticed how dirty that lid is. It's like all clouded up. That thing is fucking dirty. I watched the stream before. That is just ugh.
With each other?
Yeah.
No, we can't. No.
I just can't do it anymore, man.
Here she goes again.
Rose from Steven Universe. I have no idea who that is, man.
You're too big even for Rose.
I have no idea who that is. I don't know what that is. Is that... Is that like a Disney thing or something?
Yes.
She doesn't know who Steven Universe is. She has two children, but she doesn't know what Steven Universe is.
Special treat streams are the best. I'm not as like silly.
Medusa. Oh, I love you, Zach. I know you're watching in Discord. You bad boy, watching over in Discord instead of joining us in the chat.
Special stream. This is a Shanny has no special treats, but if you would like to get me special treats, I would not say no.
Cash App
me.
They're begging.
Book a sister up.
It's Cartoon Network. Oh, okay.
Alright. Cartoon Network.
That makes sense.
Did you guys catch the underside of that fucking pan that she just put on the stove? Holy shit. That thing was already dirty before she pulled it out.
Adult Swim stuff? Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, look, Phil. You bad boy,
chicken
Zach.
Chicken nuggets. Coke foods.
Aww.
Chicken raised with no hormones.
I honestly don't mind that you guys are watching this over in the Discord. I don't care if I'm sniped. You know, as much as seeing my viewer count go up actually gives me that good hit of dopamine, you know, you guys watch wherever you're comfortable. If you guys want to watch in the Discord where you guys can chat and abuse each other, then fine. Oh, I will abuse him, Queen. I will. I think this stream is actually abusing him more than I ever could.
Hormones or steroids. made with all white meat chicken.
White meat.
Made with that rib meat. Actually, I like rib meat chicken nuggets because it's like poor tasting, and that's actually not bad to me.
Bitch, that thing probably has about 5% white rib meat. You don't know what chicken nuggets are made of, do you? There are very few chicken nuggets out there, and they're usually higher quality and higher end chicken nuggets that actually use all meat, that actually use whole cuts of meat. I'm pretty sure that that's just an amalgamation of different chicken parts. I'm pretty sure there's like maybe 5% chicken actual rib meat in there. So yeah, you're just full of shit.
Uh-huh. But it says preheat oven to 400.
Aww.
Place frozen chicken on a foil-lined baking sheet and heat for 10 to 13 minutes. Let's stand for 3 to 5. So I'll just prepare it.
She looks like she's got two black eyes.
What was the question, huh? Oh, your kids love that brand of chicken nuggets, Indigo.
No.
Thank you, Billy Ann. You guys are so sweet.
She's stoned.
Hi, Miss Random. How are you?
She can say whatever
she wants. If I don't answer everyone's questions, I'm sorry.
She can say whatever she wants about not having special treats for this dream. This bitch is stoned out of her head. There's no way that she could come up with this unless she was fucking high. Yeah, we need the Cucked Farms. That's where Rev is. He's at the Cucked Farm. Oh yeah. Yeah, definitely. He's definitely part of the Cucked Farm. And he likes it there. He would love to be cucked. I honestly do believe that there was no better fantasy for him than for them to find someone who's willing to actually plow his sow here. And I don't need my coffee now. Oh yeah. But hey, Miss Mud Duck. But yeah, I honestly do believe that Rev's fantasy is to find someone who would be willing to plow his sow, and so that way he can hold her hand while she's getting rammed by the bull, and then do cleanup duty afterward. Because we all know that his little pee-pee has not seen the inside of her gray twat waffle. There's too much there between the two.
I apologize. It's going by really fast.
Yeah, G-Man said no.
What did I get my kid for his birthday present? Well, let's just say I made him very happy this year by getting him a 200 gigabyte SD card.
For his Switch.
For his Switch, so.
Yeah.
Speaking of Switches, I actually got one myself today. Poor Ratty, exhausted and dealing with and having to watch this shit. That's what I do. That's what I do. But yeah, I actually went and got myself a Switch. I've always wanted one, and I got the Switch Lite because I don't have a TV, so there's no point in me having the docking stand and everything. So I just got the Switch Lite. But yeah.
I asked my son, was it big enough? He said, "Yes, Mom. I downloaded all the games and I still have the room." So
there you go.
So
I need to get me an SD card for mine.
I did my motherly duty, and I got my son some righteous SD card for his birthday that he'd been wanting so he can play all his Switch games.
Amen.
And he came in and he was like, "Mom, I am playing my Mario Party." And I'm like, "Right on, son."
He's a happy boy.
He really is, man.
He's a happy boy.
He really is.
Oh, Lord. Rev just talked about Zach like he's fucking Gavin. I don't know if he's talking about Gavin or if he's talking about Zach. Really. It's like, serious. They, oh my god, the way that these two talk is just, and Shanny talks to him, they talk to each other like I talk to my dog.
Right.
We're broke, but we could still make the boy happy.
Exactly, know? Man.
Praise God.
I will say, St. Ratty, the little bit that I've actually managed to play of it today before I got on stream, the Switch Lite is still really, really good. So if you don't have any need for the docking station or to put it on a TV for any reason, definitely suggest going with the Switch Lite. It's definitely, definitely. Absorb the abuse, Zach. Absorb it. Just take it all in. Just absorb it, take it in, let it make your soul stronger and your constitution stronger. Oh, Queenie, save some spanking for me. I'll bring Mama Shaw's fire hose flogger.
Exactly, that's the one thing he wanted.
Yeah,
he'd been asking months for that SD card.
Yeah, and we have to help Will now too.
Yes.
Oh goodness, let me read Tubian's comment real quick. You don't need to feel morally conflicted about eating our chicken. At Cuck Cluck Farms, our chickens want to die, so hee ya ya. I love that, Tubian. That was good. That was good.
We'll get that done too.
Yeah, man.
The Lord will provide.
Yeah, he will.
The Lord always provides, because he is good.
He is good.
He is good.
He is good.
He is a good God.
He's a good God.
Yeah, he provided you guys a quick way out of that apartment that you destroyed.
Where do I work? I ain't telling no one where I work.
In other words, she don't work.
No. Little internet secret, don't tell anyone on the internet where you work at all. Because there are people on the internet that will call where you work and get you fired. So, nope.
Okay, little bit of background. Shanny got fired from her job being basically a janitor at a group home because she was making live streams on YouTube when she was supposed to be answering phones and listening out for the people who lived in the group home. And from what I understand, she did not even complete her 90-day probationary period that most jobs have. So, yeah, she got herself fired because she was making live streams on YouTube and she got caught.
Yeah, that's true.
Don't think so. Don't want it.
She just picked her nose.
Don't need it.
She just picked her nose.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I'm going to provide for my family.
Yeah.
Yeah, you provided them a road trip from hell. And I will say this much, one of the things that I do want to watch at some point and go over and commentate on is definitely going to be the road trip from hell. So there we go.
I'm just reading only positive comments, please.
Yeah.
She's only reading the positive comments, guys.
Ooh, what was that, Indigo? I just grilled food today. Made some marinated pork tenderloin medallions, grilled summer squash, homemade stir-fried rice, mac and cheese, and buttered Brussels sprouts. Ooh, that sounds so good. That sounds so good.
Ugh.
Yeah, Shanny, what we want to see is the inside of your dirty-ass hand.
Yeah, it's Subway. Oh, these cupcakes smell so good.
Is that the cupcakes?
Look at them. They're looking gorgeous.
Could I look?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, Shanny, just let out all the heat in the oven.
I have another...
Oh, look at how beautiful...
I have more batter in the fridge.
Do you?
Yeah, so I figured what I could do is I can make some carrot cake pancakes with it. I'll just water it down a little bit.
Don't water it down.
I love you.
You do make me like
don't water it down. It's soupy enough. Ugh, Shanny, we don't want to see the inside of your fucking hand.
I just saw Mrs. Fucking Wonderful.
What?
Is she in my room?
No way, really?
No, I don't think so. Mrs. Fucking Wonderful, my girl.
That'd be.
I love her. I think she's awesome. Thank you, Rhonda.
I think she's cool.
Ugh.
Yeah. Oh.
Rev looks like a child back there, just waiting for mommy to cook him supper.
Oh, honey.
Yes.
Just to let you know, there's a new iPhone update.
Okay.
Just to let you know.
Thank you. Beautiful. Oh, how are the tacos? Oh my God.
Amazing.
Like.
Okay, so this was after the infamous taco stream. This was after the infamous homemade tortilla stream. So she's had that eye makeup on for at least a day. and she wonders why she has rashes breaking out all over her face.
The boys had all the leftovers. We still have leftovers of it.
Of course you do.
The boys had a bunch of it and just adored it.
Yeah, I'm sure they did.
I got the best thumbnail of my career so far out of that, Shanny. Yeah, even you were saying that was a good thumbnail, right?
Yes. Scotland doesn't have tacos. What?
What?
You can make tacos in Scotland, though.
Where she is.
You know?
I mean,
thank you, Queen, for sharing the real recipe for muffins. Yeah. Hi, Knitting Gamer.
Oh, okay.
Oh my goodness, you pierced your eardrum? Oh, damn, that must have hurt like hell. Oh. Vegetarian for being chili? Oh, we're actually going to have what's a pretty much a staple in our house, and that is scrambled eggs and rice. Mama Shaw knows how to make that really, really good, too. Oof, it's delicious. But, oh my goodness, I am so sorry about your pierced eardrum. Holy shit, that must hurt like hell.
These are so good. I can't wait. I'm looking forward to tonight's meal for some reason. Because it's like a kid meal. Like, what kid doesn't like chicken nuggets and mac and cheese?
Well, when the mac and cheese will make you sick, I imagine.
And broccoli and cheese, like...
So much cheese.
If I was a kid, I'd be happy as a clam.
You're happy as long as you're stuffing your face. Or getting high. Or both. Most of the time, it's both.
I don't know. People still love freaking chicken nuggets, let's be honest. It's like one of the biggest selling things in McDonald's.
Definitely.
I will not eat McDonald's chicken nuggets, though. Those things taste weird.
I think I could fit all these in. Good. Good. The boys are going to have, like... awesome lunch tomorrow. They're probably gonna make chicken nugget sandwiches.
Yeah. How much you want to bet those chicken nuggets are not gonna survive the rest of the night?
I'm guessing. Happy clam in the sand. Oh, that looks so good. Get meat-free nuggets. Well, I didn't get the meat free, because, you know, price-wise. All right, thank you, Dragon King. Can we watch you eat? Well, probably what's going to... Oh, he already did his mukbang today.
Yeah.
Well, no. I can't watch to eat, and I'll tell you why.
Because she's gonna be having most of that.
This dinner, we're gonna be watching Space Jam. So we're gonna have some family private time. So I'm sorry, guys, you won't be able to see me eat this food. But
what she's not telling you is she's making this excuse, but she doesn't want to go on camera with the entire pot of this macaroni and cheese because her kids wouldn't touch the shit. I imagine that her kids only ate the chicken nuggets and that was it.
I will be eating it with my sons and we'd be watching a movie together. So please forgive me. I hope you understand.
No, I don't understand, Shanny. That's because you don't want people to see that you're going to eat the entire pot of macaroni and cheese.
I love you.
They're big. They're no different than like McDonald's size. Nuggets.
Like I said, I will not eat McDonald's chicken nuggets.
I think
it
might be the angle. Thank you, Billy Ann. Oh, that'd be a good movie to watch tonight. Poltergeist?
Yes, let's watch Poltergeist with your underage autistic son. Let's watch that. Oh my god, you guys, with this Cuck Cluck Farms, we need that as a t-shirt. Somebody with artistic talent, get on that. We need that for a t-shirt. I'll put it up in my store if someone makes the design.
They look like McDonald's nuggets. They probably will taste like McDonald's nuggets.
In other words, they'll taste like shit.
Possibly. I don't know. Maybe. You're gonna watch it with your family tonight? That's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah, I'm having a wonderful night. I'm just waiting for this water to be done boiling.
You should have figured that into your cook
time.
The
new Space Jam? No. The old Space Jam.
Yeah, the new one doesn't come out until July 16th or something.
Yeah, he definitely wants to watch. It's LeBron James, right?
Yeah.
That's doing it? Yeah.
King
James. I reject the new Space Jam. Ooh, we got some shade there, man.
It looks awesome.
Do I have merch? Yes, I have merch. If you go to RevandShanny.com.
That's right.
You will see my merch.
That's right.
And it looks like shit. They actually have. They actually bought their own merch. It looks like
crap. I've never seen Space Jam, so I'm looking forward to seeing it. Plus, I get to see it with my sons while eating some mac and cheese and chicken nuggets and some broccoli and cheese. I'm a happy clam, trust me.
She's not going
to.
Did you guys see that little? I mean, if you guys didn't come to the beginning of the stream, she showed off the bag of broccoli and cheese that she's going to make, which is one of those small steamer bags from Bird's Eye. And oh no, the water hasn't even started to boil. She did not figure in that the fact that they're at a higher altitude means there's going to be a longer boiling time for the water. She didn't figure that into her cook time. She's currently baking the terrible carrot cake cupcakes with giant pineapple chunks. That's what's in the oven right now. And my God, if her stovetop looks like this, I don't even want to imagine what her fucking oven looks like. But yeah, so she hasn't even put those in the oven. She hasn't put those nuggets in the oven. She just took them out of the bag and put them on the pan. But right now she's baking the cupcakes, which are going to turn out to be terrible because she used aluminum foil as a cupcake tin, as a cupcake liner. And then she put oil in the bottom of the tin. So that's... I'm so glad I don't have to eat her cooking.
A happy clam.
Well, I mean, cats, you forget Shanny eats for four people. Just by herself. Oh, that
you
laugh.
Have Space Jam on Vudu? Okay. What? Shannon, you will love Space Jam. I hope I love it.
Yes, Lucian. She tried to make her own homemade tortillas.
You think Space Jam is G-Man's favorite movie of all time? It might be, actually. That one's like, if you were joking, that wouldn't surprise me if that was actually like a joke statement or a true statement. I don't know.
Oh my goodness.
I'll just be honest with you. Michael Jackson's music video jam epic.
Yeah.
Everything about Michael was epic.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Miles Barker. Thank you. Probably not gonna have it for very long.
Probably talking about the house.
Trying to keep it.
Shanny, even with the fact that the setup that you and Rev had was actually a pretty interesting one, and it was garnering you views and therefore ad revenue. There's no way that you would have been able to make enough in order to pay a $3,000 a month rent. No way on God's green earth. No YouTuber, I think, could make that much money just on their YouTube channel. They would have to have another job, which we all know that you weren't going to get one and Rev wasn't going to get one. So you both were both were depending on YouTube. And you didn't think to, I don't know, move into a cheaper apartment or maybe when you had $700,000 buying a house. You didn't think about that. But of course, then if you had thought about it, we wouldn't have the wonderful saga that we're currently watching right now, which is you desperately trying to make money on YouTube, trying to disguise yourself, although we all know it's you.
I'm trying, but it's getting to be a challenge at this point.
All right, Saint Ratty, take care.
Did you say Rev and Shanny? Yes, RevandShanny.com. Baby? Oh, happy birthday to your son, Rhonda. Happy birthday. Are the cupcakes done? No, not yet. They're going to be. They're smelling really good, though.
Mm-hmm. Something can smell good, but still taste like shit.
Done.
They might be done, actually. It bounced back. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah, I think they're done.
Oh, it's done.
It's done. Okay, so the cupcakes did cook all the way through.
Move this aside real quick.
Let's take a look at these beautiful cupcakes that she made. With her tinfoil cupcake liners. They gonna get that t-shirt?
My sons, I love them.
I don't know where it is. I have to see if I can look around at the different, at least the streams that I know of over cooking streams. But there's apparently a cooking stream out there where she was cooking and she stood up to do something and she leaned over the stove and her tits messed with the fucking touchpad there. So she turned on the stove with her boobs.
Alright. Set that to 400.
My baby.
Holy shit, she has an oven mitt.
Oh.
They look fine, guys.
Look at all that tinfoil.
They look fine and beautiful. Oh. And they smell gorgeous.
Ooh.
I know.
Oh my goodness, they're so pretty.
Yeah, those look fantastic, guys. What are you talking about? They look delicious. Don't you want some of that? Don't you want some of that tin foil in your system? You get plenty of aluminum.
Oh.
How does it smell?
Oh my god, I want it now. What do you think?
You know what I did in the replacement of the water?
What?
I added the pineapple juice that was in the can.
Oh no, Zach. That's not banana bread. That's not banana bread. That is carrot cake that's carrot cake batter with huge pineapple chunks in them. So yeah.
That's a great idea.
See?
Yeah. You know what you're doing.
Exactly.
I think she's going to be getting to the piece de resistance soon, which is the fucking macaroni
and cheese.
Then
in a few minutes, we'll have chicken nuggets. Now, are you boiling yet? No, you're not.
She did not figure that out.
Have you noticed that's the only thing about this stove? It takes forever for water to boil.
It's because you ruined the burners, Shanny. You have ruined those burners. Not to mention the fact that you are in Colorado, which is a higher altitude than Pennsylvania. It's going to take a lot longer for water to boil. You should have figured that into your cooking time, but you didn't because you're a dumbass.
I think that's every stove, though, to be honest with you.
They're mild nocturnal activity perpetual? Yeah.
Yes, I am doing cream cheese frosting, actually.
Ugh. I wish we could have seen her make the cream cheese frosting, but she doesn't. She makes macaroni cheese, and I think that's where it ends.
Add a little salt to the water. That might.
Oh, Lord. Here she goes. Time to get that pink Himalayan salt shaker. Salt grinder.
Did you guys know that I'm like a salt connoisseur?
Yeah.
We know you're salty.
I have so many different types of salts and collect salts. I've had black salt. I prefer Himalayan pink salt.
Yeah.
Excuse me, that is salt of color, Shanny.
I think it all, in my opinion, it has the most health benefits to it.
She's just going to add a little salt, guys. Just a little salt to the water.
And kosher salt as well.
I love kosher salt.
Yeah. You're going to add just a little bit of salt. Just a touch. Just a little bit of salt.
Yeah.
A little bit of salt.
There.
Beautiful.
What am I going to do the mac and cheese? We'll find out. We'll find out.
Yeah.
Maybe it's a water secret. Stain on the fucking stove.
Yeah.
I mean, because if you guys want to pause it, if I know there's that play thing over there. Ignore my Nyan cat. But look at the burner right here. That burner is toasted. That burner is done. No wonder things take so long to cook on those burners. Because holy shit, you've ruined the burners. And there we go. There's our dear sweet friend, Marco Solo. Oh, I hope Shanny comes back onto the... Hope Shanny eventually reveals her face or I get some of her nice little Instagram streams so I can follow the journey of Marco Solo. Because I'm invested in Marco Solo.
That's Kroger Private Selection Himalayan Salt Grinder. That's right. I don't mind it. I love Himalayan salt.
It doesn't have to be like McCormick.
No.
Oh, whatever. Imported from Scandinavia. I don't know.
It just has to be from that area.
It's got to be straight
from a salt mine.
The Peruvian, you know, Everglades area of Plains, where they gather the best of salts.
Oh, remember that Hawaiian sea salt I had?
Yes.
That you left behind in your previous house?
That was the best salt I think I ever had.
The Hawaiian sea salt.
The Hawaiian sea salt, yeah.
So good.
That's like $75 a pound or something, isn't it?
And that $75 a pound salt... is probably in the garbage. Long since in the garbage. Because I guarantee that she probably had this in a previous house that they were in. Or a previous apartment that they were in. And when they eventually got kicked out of there, she left it behind. Because Shanny doesn't pack shit.
Yeah.
You get a pound of it for $75. But it's very good.
Yes.
It's very good salt.
Very, 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 very.
And you'll get crazy minerals. Right?
She wonders why she's swelling.
There's lots of minerals. You'll be making yourself like a super
bean. You know, I cooked cupcakes. I put them in the tins.
I know.
I waited for cupcakes to freaking, like, the cupcakes are already baked and the water is still not boiled.
Holy crap, I know it's true.
Because you've ruined that stove, Shanny. That's why they're not
like,
boiled.
Boil water.
Hey, water. Could you
freaking
boil for
flip's
sake?
Yeah, boil.
Yeah,
Rev, sleeves are your friends, darling. Sleeves are your friend. Ugh. Magical. Isn't that just a perfect couple? Absolute puckle.
I made my mac and cheese couple with dehydrated gold. Cheese. Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Hey, Nina.
How about those crazy folks that, How about those crazy folks that eat, like, 70-year-old MREs?
All the seven... Have you seen those YouTube videos where those guys eat 70-year-old, like, MREs, and they eat, like, old boxes of mac and cheese? And...
Nasty.
I know, right?
He's talking about that being nasty, but yet he eats
like,
this woman shit.
LAB, drink that Crystal Pepsi. And he vomited so bad.
Rev, shut the fuck up. Crystal Pepsi is the shit, okay?
Is the counter broken? Yes. Yes, it is.
Yeah, that's true.
And why haven't you gotten a maintenance man in those
pictures? It happened today, in fact.
Limestone erosion.
I don't know how it happened. It just happened.
Limestone
erosion. Rev is blaming their broken granite countertop on limestone erosion. I'm not making it up. He just said it. We all know it's because your fat ass sat on it, Shanny, or leaned on it or something, and those countertops are not designed to take that kind of pressure. But here's the good question. Why haven't you called a maintenance man in to repair it? Gee, I wonder. It couldn't have anything to do with the fact that you have destroyed that apartment.
Limestone erosion because of the water flow.
Oh, yeah. Another tidbit. Never called a maintenance man in. The youngest son's bathroom, her youngest son's bathroom, the one that had the dirty, nasty toilet and all the garbage in there, the light was not working in that bathroom. The light had gone out. So instead of either her replacing the bulb or her calling someone to replace the bulb, he just had to piss in the dark. So yeah, I don't blame it. Yeah. Yeah, I know. It's like, it's Kraft macaroni and cheese. You're about to see how she screws this shit up.
I guess that's what happened. It was patch job before we got here, so it needs to get...
Bull fucking shit. Bullshit. When you moved into this apartment, it was a brand new apartment. They had just been built. You two idiots were the first occupants of these apartments. And they were luxury apartments. $3,000 a month. $3,000 a month for these apartments. You were the first ones to live in there. So don't give me that bullshit about a patch job. No, your fat ass broke it and you won't call in a maintenance man to fix it because they would come in and see the state of that apartment and you would immediately get thrown out.
Tacked
quicker than you did
again,
before.
Yeah, it's
no big deal.
Nah.
Maintenance.
Exactly. Maintenance. Your patch job didn't work.
Bro.
You ain't called maintenance in that apartment one time. Yes, Queenus Bay. Tiny Dinger Condoms has sponsored a couple of my streams. Thank you, Tiny Dinger Condoms, for having these two pieces of shit covered.
Three boxes, laugh out loud. Why are you laughing about that? It's my son's birthday.
It's feeding four people.
It's feeding two teenagers.
Yeah. Actually, it should be
no, it's feeding you.
That's
and she just drops that cardboard on the floor.
Like pick petty.
I know.
Nah, 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 nah. Nah, 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 nah.
But it can't be like this.
Okay, Jason, can you not be so loud?
Yeah, Jason,
God.
I'm trying to film. Don't be so loud.
I can hear you. We're in the same room.
I just called you down here to be my background
it's
dancer.
It's boiling.
Praise Jesus.
One box can feed a family of four. Tiny Dinger Condoms are a thing. You can go look on Queen of Spades' channel. She has the commercials for them. But, one box can feed a family of four. Now, I will admit, I am a fat ass. I can eat a box of macaroni and cheese on my own. But I usually don't have anything else with it. Just the macaroni and cheese. That's my comfort food. But one box of macaroni and cheese can feed a family of four. But considering the fact that Shanny eats for herself, can herself eat for a family of four? That doesn't surprise me that they're using three boxes.
Don't ever put oil in my water. They don't stick.
I put oil in my water.
I hear him, man. What? What are you guys talking about? Let me just go check this out.
She's so concerned with what the chat's saying. I'll tell you what, there's a guy I watch on YouTube, and his is just baking ASMR. That's all it is. He makes the most intricate fucking desserts I've ever seen. It's absolutely amazing. I watch him. I listen to him. He does not say a word during the entire video. It's just baking ASMR. It's wonderful. It's absolutely fantastic. And the shit that he makes, oh my God, I wish I could get a hold of that shit. Like, he made a watermelon jelly tart. And it's just, oh my God, it looks so good. I would want a piece of that so bad. And he makes his own ganache and everything. And he doesn't say a word during the entire fucking video. It's absolutely amazing. I think his name's like Cacao something or something. I can't remember exactly what it is. He pops up every now and then. But, I mean, it's just absolutely fantastic, the shit that he makes. And the fact that he does this without speaking.
Oh, there I am. You're cute, baby.
I love you.
I love you.
You're beautiful.
She looks like she has two black eyes.
Where are you going?
I'm going back upstairs.
You sure?
Yeah. I love you.
I love you too.
Do you see?
Taste the cupcake.
Okay, I hate to pause this. Well, I don't hate to pause this again because you guys know how much I love to talk. Do you see how clingy she is even now, even in Colorado? It's like he wants to go back upstairs and do his own thing. She's like, oh, where are you going? Why are you leaving me? Oh, please come back. You can hear it in her voice. She wants him to sit there quietly like a good little boy and be her little background decoration while she does this terrible fucking stream.
No. I am not. I refuse. Don't want to taste the cupcake yet. Don't need to.
No, because she's going to let her kids eat all that tinfoil.
Never saw that one either, but everyone says that movie is great. Why did Rev leave? Probably because I told him to tone down his voice. He like, in his head, I say, please don't yell. In his head, it's me telling him to shut up. No, it's not. It's telling him, don't yell. Okay.
Turn it down,
Shanny.
I need
Shanny. To put some oil in.
Yes, add oil to already boiling water.
There. Calm down.
Maybe if you turn
little trick,
the burner
if that happens,
down, you're supposed
some oil
to
in.
Turn it down.
We all make a great couple, very in tune to another. Well, we've known each other for like 10 years.
Well, I mean, Queen of Spade, I'm not saying it's not something that I personally would eat. Pineapple and carrot muffins. But I'm pretty sure that the pineapple and the carrots are, I'm pretty sure the pineapple is not in these huge chunks like she put into this thing. Shanny can take anything and just any kind of concept and just completely and utterly destroy it. That's kind of her thing. Yes. Kind of what she's known for.
We should be able to know each other that well. Like, I love my husband, don't get me wrong, but I don't understand why he takes me saying don't yell as, like, shut up.
Maybe he wanted to go back upstairs and
it's
do his own
like,
fucking
thing.
It's just
like, don't raise your voice, I can hear you. But he, like, gets so excited that his voice raises like a child, and I think it's because he was an only child, and his mother didn't tell him to shut the fuck up. Like, you know how children, like...
It could also be because you gave him irreversible brain damage when you forced him to quit alcohol cold turkey. I mean, that could be an issue. It could be because I know that a couple of people that I had that had traumatic brain injuries and strokes, they couldn't modulate their voice either. So it could be the fact that you gave him irreversible brain damage when you forced him to quit alcohol. Or it could just be because he's a fucking dumbass. That too. Hi, GA.
Like, progressively, when they get more excited they get, the louder they become. And you have to tell them to shut up. He didn't get that. So he has no volume control or known volume control.
So you yell at your boys to shut up all the time? Now I wonder why they don't talk. Ugh, now she's
10 years, that is a long time. It is. Very long time we've been together. Well, not been together. We've been together for only like 3.5 years, but we've known each other for 10.
You were together a lot longer than that because if I remember correctly, one of the reasons why you got divorced was because you were having phone sex with Rev. And your brother-in-law caught you, and that's one of the reasons why you decided to assault him. Was because he caught you having phone sex with Rev. And he wasn't too happy about it. So yeah. And if nobody believes me, you can actually go find it on the Fundy archive. It's a stream where she's sitting in her mom's backyard crying her eyes out because her and Chris got divorced. And you can even hear her say that Chris found out they were having phone sex with each other. So yeah, she was with Rev a lot longer, if not the entire time that she was with Chris. She was hitting Rev up because Rev had money. And she wanted to be able to use that money to sit on her ass and not doing anything. Well, that worked out great for you, Shanny. Hi from the future. where you're living in destitution and starvation and in the poverty line while you're sucking off of his uncle because Rev no longer has any money.
I sense you are done, little one. Let's see.
And of course, you got to eat it to try. Just make sure. And touch your spoon with your dirty ass hand that you've been picking your nose with, and then stick the spoon in the water.
I am correct.
And now, where are you gonna drain the water at? You've done filled your sink up with garbage.
Stop boiling before I drain it. For sheer reasons of I'm not very steady. You were talking about your harem of men.
You wish you could have a harem of men, Shanny. Don't lie. You wish you could have had a harem. You wish you could have a harem of men, but ain't nobody gonna be fucking you.
How did we meet? We met here on YouTube. We met on YouTube, talked on and off on Facebook about Jesus throughout the
years. Yeah, I'm sure it was just Jesus.
Started talking on Skype.
Where you had phone sex.
I was married at the time, so we were talking with, you know, my other spouse at the time.
You were cucking Chris.
We were talking about Jesus. And then one day, my husband decided to cheat on me with my best friend. Devastated me, completely destroyed me as a person. And a couple months later, me and Jason just started talking to each other and we fell in love. And then
okay, let me just clear this up for guys who have not been following this sow. First of all, she did lay hands on her ex-husband. He's admitted to it that she has hit him before. Couple that with the fact that she also laid hands on his brother, and then also the fact that she was having phone sex with Rev, and Rev was actually paying their bills, too. And that, because there is one story that Chris told where she had called Rev about paying, I think it was their utility bill or their light bill or something, and when she was talking to him, she said, "Okay, I love you, baby." And not only did Chris hear this, but his mother heard it too. So not only did she say this in front of Chris, she said it in front of his mother, her mother-in-law. And so yeah, that's what all that led up to him making throat babies with her best friend, which I say, good for you, Chris. Have at it. I normally would not say anything. I would normally would not condone cheating of any type. Any kind, because I think that adults should be able to handle their relationships in a mature way, but you know what? If he was dealing with all that shit, you go for it, dude. You go and you throat fuck the fuck out of that damn bitch. And to hell with what Shanny thinks.
And I moved out to where he was, and then we moved to Colorado, and then, you know, here we are. Thank you, Langley. I shout sometimes, and my mom said, say, what?
What? Of course you can't understand. You can't read.
Hi, B. McGregor. Don't treat women like that in my chat.
Look at that. That's a lot of ass. That's the ass that got her in trouble. Right there. That's the ass that got her Twitch taken away. All that ass. Look at all that ass. That's what got her in trouble. Nope. Now she's gonna ruin the macaroni and cheese.
Doing. All right.
And the burner's not completely now. Cooled down, so the so now the macaroni and cheese is now frying.
We're gonna prepare this like we normally do. Baby?
Jason? Oh my god. I want to say maybe it's been maybe 10 minutes and already she's calling Rev down.
Alright. Never mind. We got some Kerrygold.
Oh, my
yes.
God.
Kerrygold Irish butter, okay? Listen, it's my son's birthday. We're gonna splurge with Kraft macaroni and cheese. We're gonna put that fancy butter in there.
Oh my God, she puts the whole stick. Watch
there's
this.
There's no greater butter than Kerrygold. It is the best butter.
She put the whole fucking stick in there.
You can't, like, not love it. It's just divine.
And she put the whole fucking stick in there.
Exactly.
The best it is.
Butter up, biatches. That's right, a whole stick of butter. I put that in there.
You're supposed to chop it up, Shanny, so it has an easier time melting within the hot noodles.
Whole
you're not
stick
supposed
of
to
butter.
Dump the whole stick in there whole.
Mm-hmm. I didn't pitch the penny either. It's good butter.
Yeah, damn good butter.
Then a little bit of milk.
Just
put
a little
that
bit.
In there.
Just a little bit of milk, guys.
Yep.
She had that milk sitting on her counter. It's gonna take that butter forever to melt.
And we're just gonna stir that. Oh yeah, that good macaroni and cheese sound. Oh yeah. That's the sound.
It's gonna take forever for that. Look, this whole stick is still in there.
Oh my God. Right.
She's not trying to mush it up or anything. You see
oh
it
my
floating
God.
Around.
It looks so good. It smells so good.
Do you know those, Shanny? Hmm. No, never mind. Gotta keep that G rated.
Oh my God.
Thank you. There's a lot of
I like but
self-censored.
Thank you.
Yep.
I will say this much. I like fucking butter. I like a lot of butter in my macaroni and cheese. I really do. But I do not just throw the whole stick in there willy-nilly. I cut that shit up so it has an easier time melting. But it's about to get a lot worse, folks. It's gonna get a lot worse.
So, it's my son's birthday, don't judge me.
She's putting sour cream in there.
We're doing the doo-doo to the dollop with Daisy.
Oh my goodness, wow.
Yep.
Put sour cream in there.
Yep.
And Mexican.
He asked specifically for me to do this.
I'm sure he did. I'm
sure
he did.
Deluxe mac and cheese with Kraft.
I'm sure he
wanted to be blocked up. Two handfuls of cheese.
Oh.
I'm sure he wanted to be blocked up from
honey, crush these.
Okay. That's fun.
The leftover Doritos?
Yeah. Okay.
So your son wanted... get worse. So your son wanted to be backed up for a month and to have put in his macaroni and cheese the leftovers from a bag of Doritos that had everybody's nasty ass hands in it. Okay, sure thing. All right, Jan, keep talking.
We're gonna crush them up.
Okay, these are the nacho cheese ones?
Yep. Oh yeah.
Still see a stick of butter in there.
What?
A stick of butter is still in.
Crushed up nacho cheese.
A stick of butter's holding on.
You're gonna lose it. The birthday boy's here. Oh, he's excited.
Zach, don't get on camera, honey, please.
Yeah, we got.
Thank you.
Filming in progress.
Yeah,
you're
welcome.
Welcome.
We love you. Here.
Filming in progress.
You want me to put it in?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go, folks. You ready for the deluxe Dorito toss? Oh my God.
Oh.
What?
Okay, let's do it.
Oh, the sound. Yeah.
I'm gonna do it for you guys. Okay.
Yeah.
Let me sit down.
We're gonna be singing. We're gonna be hearing our national anthem, guys.
I want to do something special for you guys.
Everybody, salute.
I love cheese. Ba-bum. I love cheese. Ba-bum. I love cheese.
Ba-bum.
Yes, I do. I love cheese.
Ba-bum.
I love cheese.
Ba-bum.
I love cheese.
Ba-bum.
Yes, I do. Look at that cheese pool. Look at this. Oh yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, God.
Let's get that sound for you.
That sounds so nasty.
Oh, yeah. That is Mama's special mac and cheese.
That is sure to
directly
give you...
from my son's orders. I think I did the job.
Yeah.
And the chicken nuggies are done.
Chicken nuggies.
Yes.
Bro, oh, it smells so good here now.
Oh, look at them. Oh.
I will say the chicken nuggets are probably the most appetizing thing of this entire meal. Hi, Red Feather.
Some mac and cheese, Zach style.
Oh my God, no. Don't feed
some
that to your child.
Some delicious chicken nuggets. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh, you're gonna be happy.
And then I'm gonna pop this in for 5 minutes.
Yeah, bro.
Hi, Six Drops.
Yeah, that's correct.
And that's pretty much my mac and cheese and carrot cake cooking show. I'm gonna go and feed my children
and have them back
and watch some Space Jam. You, my fellow people, you have a good
hold on,
night.
Wait a second.
Cooking show. I'm gonna go and feed my children and watch some Space Jam. You, my fellow people.
My, I caught a glimpse into that fucking sink where she's been throwing her garbage into.
Bull. You have a good night. I'm gonna see you soon, I promise. And I am planning on doing another live stream later tonight. Hopefully. Let's find out. Maybe the kids will, like, I'll be burnt out. But we'll find out. I want to do a video game. I want to play games. I don't know. We'll find out. I'll see you guys. Have a great night. Peace and Maranatha. Love you guys. Stay tuned. Tomorrow, I'm going to do another one. Okay. Tomorrow, you guys are going to love this for tomorrow, okay? Tomorrow, I am going to be making my vegetarian barbecue chicken. Wink, wink, with a butternut risotto.
Oh my God.
A butternut squash risotto. That's tomorrow for you guys. So stay tuned. We're gonna pick up this
If the food wasn't appetizing enough, just look at that wonderful face. Just look at that beautiful face and just imagine how wonderful this woman's food tastes. Oh my goodness. It's delicious. Delicious. And like I said, if you can find the stream and you go and watch it, you can see in their fridge and there is a shit ton of leftovers in that fridge. Yeah, the risotto. She can't say risotto. She says risotto. But yeah. All that nasty ass food that she cooked was left in that fridge. So ain't nobody eating that fucking shit. Nobody's eating. Vegetarian chicken, right? Actually, I do have that stream. It's on XX Archive. She has that stream where she makes the vegetarian barbecue chicken. And she makes it out of sweet potatoes. Just to let you guys know. But yeah, we're going to get to the end of the stream and then we're going to go into our musical number, which is actually by our very own dear friend, Red Feather One. Yes, I am replaying your song, so I hope you guys enjoy it. And I will see you guys the next time I decide to stream, which I don't know when that's going to be. But I am hoping that getting this new computer will be able to help with a little bit with the quality. I may just have to upgrade my internet, I don't know. But we'll see. But anyway, this is... going to be the end of it, and I will see you guys next time. Please stick around for the musical number. Yeah, nobody's blocked. Well, I mean, I don't have anybody blocked. I don't know about individual people, but I don't have anybody personally blocked on this channel. So, yeah.
Cooking thing up a notch for you guys, and I'm going to show you how amazing cooking is. Bye, guys.
This video is...
All right, so guys, this is going to do it for the stream. I'm actually going to turn off our theme song for a minute. And so that way we can listen to the beautiful, beautiful music that our lovely dear friend Red Feather has created for us. And I hope you guys have enjoyed the stream, and I will see you guys the next time I decide to stream, which I don't know when that's going to be. I don't keep a set schedule. Just turn on notifications. And you can always catch it on the replay. The streams come to you. You get the entertainment whenever you want it. So you guys have a good one. Please stick around, listen to the song from Red Feather. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
Is a very specific message that I want known to everybody that knows me and Shanny, okay?
No one knows what it's like to be the reverend individual behind broke eyes. And no one knows what it's like to white Shanny, the big family that's between the sides. But my dreams, they aren't as empty as my brain waves seem. I have hours alone with Shanny. She wants a vengeance I cannot see. No one knows what it's like to be begging like I do. We need some boots. And no one crinkles a heart like you folks who cause all this pain to my channel. But my dreams, they aren't as empty as my wallet to be. We spent hours twitchy streaming with DoorDash pizza and Chinese.
You're not me, and I'm telling you, I'm the one living in this situation. Shanny is like a rock. She's everything.
If her fist clenches, crack it open before I end up really bruised. So when I cry, find me some rolling so I can come back and laugh like a fool. When she swallows all of the booze up, we'll point our fingers at PayPal. And if we shiver, she'll crochet a blanket that might be finished 5 years from now.
And this is coming from the guy that is with her, okay? I'm with her all the time.
No one knows what it's like to be the reverend individual behind broke eyes.
She's my wife, and I love her with every bit of my being. Every bit of it. I want it made clear that I love Shanny.